Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to work with MIDI and Reaper. We'll start by recording MIDI with a MIDI instrument, then we'll go over how to use some of the tools to fix those recordings, such as quantization. Lastly, we'll cover the piano roll and how to manually write out MIDI. Before checking out this video, make sure you've watched the previous ones in the series so you're all caught up. Before we get started, it's worth noting that there's a little bit of a problem with the audio recordings for this tutorial and the next one. You may hear a little bit of clicking and popping and a little bit of latency in the audio. This is because to capture the audio recordings with the screen capture for Reaper, we have to set the audio to direct sound instead of ASIO. This doesn't work properly with MIDI, so it creates these sounds, and you won't get them when you're recording with ASIO on your own system. To get started with MIDI, we'll add a new MIDI track. Right-click on the blank track area and select Insert Virtual Instrument on New Track. I'll add MT Power Drum Kit, which is a free MIDI drum VST instrument that we talked about in some other videos. When you add the virtual instrument, you'll be asked if you want to add the associated stereo outputs. We'll choose Yes for this, that way we can edit different parts of the drum kit individually. Within the plugin, we can route different parts of the kit to different tracks. I'm not going to cover that in this video since it's specific to the plugin, but you can learn about that in the MT Power Drum Kit tutorial for Reaper that's already posted on our channel. Now let's create a MIDI clip so we can edit the MIDI with the piano roll. We'll click and drag to create a time selection on our track. Then click and select our virtual instrument. Go to Insert at the top and select a new MIDI item. Now click on that MIDI item to bring up the piano roll. The first thing we should do to organize ourselves is create labels for the MIDI notes, especially since we're working with drums. This wouldn't be necessary if we're using a keyboard instead though. This will allow us to quickly see what each MIDI note is mapped to on the kit, instead of just numbers we have now. To do this, go to the File menu and select Note/CC Names and load Note/CC Names from File. We'll navigate to a file on our computer where these are stored. These mappings can be found online from MT Power Drum Kit, so we don't need to go through the tedious process of making it on our own for Reaper. As you can see, having the map is really useful since the mapping is all over the place. These can also vary by plugin or the MIDI instrument you're using. If you want to, you can do this manually from the file menu, but it is very tedious to do. With the piano roll configured, we can start drawing MIDI notes. To draw a note, click and drag at different points on the piano roll. The up and down position changes the note you're adding, and the left and right is the timing. After a note is added, you can click and drag it left or right to change the timing, or up or down to change the note value. You can also click and drag the ends of the note to change the length. To delete a note, click on it and press the delete key on the keyboard, or right-click the note and select delete. When adding notes, the position and length of the note can be determined by snapping to the grid. Snapping is enabled by default, but can be turned on and off by clicking the magnet button in the top menu. To the left of that, we can choose to view the grid lines. I like to keep these on while editing. The snapping and grid resolution is determined at the bottom. We can switch the resolution with a drop-down menu. I'll usually keep it at 8th notes or 16th notes. It's easier to map MIDI with the note resolution as large as possible, but you can always switch it if needed. There's also options for changes to the resolution, such as triplets or swing, and the swing opens a slider to change the strength from minus 100% to 100%. To the right, we have the default note length when we double-click instead of clicking and dragging. I'll usually keep this as grid so it will sync with the grid resolution. Having the default note length set incorrectly isn't too big of a deal since you can click and drag it anyway. At the bottom, we can change the velocity of each of the notes. First, we select a note on the grid, then drag the velocity bar up or down. It's useful to develop the habit of selecting the note on the grid first. This allows you to change the velocity of only one note of the overlapping notes at the same time. So if the drums hit a hi-hat and kick at the same time, we can adjust the velocity separately. Another way we can work with MIDI is to record with a MIDI controller. We start again by creating a virtual instrument or MIDI track. Then set the input to our MIDI controller. You can specify a channel to record from if you want to, otherwise all channel mode works fine. Now that it's set up, just arm the track to record and record it just like we would with an audio track. After that's done, we can open up the piano roll view by clicking on the clip. With the piano roll, we can make manual edits like we saw before, so if we hit the wrong note, off time, or with the wrong velocity, all these can be edited without having to record a new take. Let's go over some of the other things we can do from here. First is transposing the MIDI recording, which means we bring the pitch up or down for all the notes. To do this, press Ctrl A to select all the notes. Now hover over a note and click and drag to change the pitch. Just be careful not to also change the timing as you do this. Don't do this when the up or down arrow shows on the edge, or you'll be changing the velocity instead. Click on the middle of the notes. The other thing we can do is apply quantization. When we record with the MIDI controller, our timing is unlikely to be perfect. Quantization allows us to snap the timing of the notes to the grid to automatically create perfect timing. To quantize the notes, press the Q button to bring up the quantization options. We'll leave the settings as Use Grid, that way it uses the resolution that our piano roll is set to. Change this to the largest time setting possible for your clip, otherwise it is more likely that your notes will snap to the wrong position. If you're playing all 8th notes, set it to 8th notes. If you set it to 16th notes, you can have a note snapping in between where it should be instead. Then we'll choose to quantize all notes by position. For a percussion track, we don't need to worry much about the note end since the plugins just respond to the note instantaneously. For a keyboard or synth, we'll also want to quantize note length or end position so they end at the right time. I'll keep the strength at 100% and then press OK to apply it. After you've applied it, listen back to your clips to make sure it hasn't snapped the wrong way. If it has, just manually click and drag the MIDI event to the proper position. Another thing we can do is route MIDI clips on virtual instrument tracks to audio tracks. This doesn't play anything on the audio tracks, but it can allow us to control plugins on that track. One example is with AutoTune. There's a free plugin called G-Snap AutoTune that works with Reaper, and it can be programmed to work with MIDI input to snap the voice to those notes, as we covered in a previous video on this channel. To get this working, open the signal routing on the track we'll apply the AutoTune plugin to. Then add a new receive as the MIDI track. After that, we can set our plugin to follow these MIDI events, but that depends on the plugin. Thanks for checking out this video on recording and editing MIDI in Reaper. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for products featured in this video and links to social media accounts so you can stay up to date on all our new content.